Hello there and welcome. My name's Fiona from Weekly Sewing Bee, and today we're going to make a pair of fingerless gloves out of the sleeve of an old fleece. So just standard fleece here. Now what we need is we need the measurements of our hand. Now we can do that quite easily, and this sleeve's quite nice because it's on the fold, so it's quite nice. Makes the life a little bit easier for us. If not, we just have to sew it up, but we do have to take that line into consideration. Now, I have no problems with fingerless gloves not joining in the middle, but I do like to have my thumb out. So I'm going to literally draw around my thumb. Now, I can see that my hand goes up probably about a whole inch. So I need to take that into account. So I need my inch for the excess of my hand, and then I need half an inch for my sewing allowance. So I have now got, I line that back up again, I now have got an inch and half an inch, and then this lower line is going to be my actual hand, and my outer line is going to be my my glove. So I'm going to take my sleeve and I'm going to use this as a pattern. Now I'm going to make use of the bottom of the cuff of the garment because I like long fingerless gloves. But if you find that your sleeve's too thin, you may need to sort of move it up slightly so that we can get to the point where it joins. It's going to be wider at the top. And then we need to hem the bottom, which is quite simple. So I can get that cut out and then we can get on with our sewing. Now, whereas most things, if you're buying a pattern or anything, then there is a list of orders to sew them in, because of it's just makes life easier, and somebody's taken the time to actually work out the order of the sewing. Now I know, because I have worked it out, that I'm going to sew the top first. So I'm just going to ask the sewing machine to stitch a couple of reverse stitches. Now, fleece is a lovely material. It doesn't need seams to stop it from fraying. It's slightly stretch, and in a way, it's like sewing butter. It really is. So I could quite happily sew six layers of fleece, and it would just be fine. The only problem is that maybe my foot wouldn't go high enough. Okay. So that's the seam at the top of the fingers. I'm going to now place this together and I'm going to sew down the fingers and the thumb. Now you can see here that I've got my sewing line drawn on. It's on the inside and it is just a matter of following that line. Now I'm sure there's some people that can sew seam around the thumb. Now I'm not one of those people, so what I'm going to do is before I sew up the side, I'm now going to open the thumb seam out and I'm going to just sew the thumb seam now. Now you can, if you want to, if you're happy to do that, you can cut this and then recut it after you've done the sewing. Makes life a lot easier. Now, I've flattened out that seam. What I've done is I've taken, rather than pushing both sides, I've opened it out to get it nice and smooth and flat. And all I'm doing now is I'm sewing the thumb seam. And each time I stop the sewing machine, even if I'm going to recut it, I re-sew over all those points. Now the last seam, unless of course you're not going down as far as the bottom, if we were doing it to higher up the seam than at the bottom, then we would just fold this over and put a line of stitches, making sure that it would be on the outside, so all our seams are now showing. And it's fine. You know, fleece is very durable. It's a man-made fabric, and it's made out of recycled plastics. And there are different qualities of fleece. Some of the stuff you can buy is non-pile. I would say this is rather the cheapest fleece you can buy, because we can see that it's already piled, and I know that it's already shrunk as well. So, and that's why I'm quite happy just to take it apart and reuse it. But I do like to have my thumb out on these mitts, because mobile phones, gripping and everything else like that. So we've now finished our sewing. We do need to trim our ends just to keep it a nice garment. And there are points in the garment where you can stop and trim your ends so you don't sew them in, because it just makes this end job quite difficult. Now, very simple, as long as we remember to get our seams done at convenient places, and we know fleece is durable, ideal for somebody like me that has to go to the stables first thing in the morning, and I can make them as long as I like, so that I can have that wrist support as well as warmth. And I have access to my thumb, so I can get in and out of doors, locks and everything else like that. Okay. Now, I didn't do a very good job of snipping those ends, did I? And managed to get ink everywhere. But how ideal is that? And trust me, I get through quite a lot of fingerless gloves, and I have the ability to grip as well, and use mobile phones, and yeah. So very simple make, ideal upcycle, and all it was is a fleece that I have I could say I'd grown out of it, but it's more of a case. It's shrunk. Okay, so thank you ever so much for watching. My name's Fiona from Weekly Sewing Bee.